जय गुरु देव स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम योर ईवीएस टीचर एंड आई विल टीच यू ईवीएस. ओके, सो चिल्ड्रन, फर्स्ट वी विल रिवाइज द ओल्डर पार्ट, मीन्स दोज टू चैप्टर्स यू हैव स्टडीड इन द मंथ ऑफ अप्रैल. एंड नंदिता मैम हैज टोल्ड यू एंड एक्सप्लेन यू दोज चैप्टर्स इन डिटेल. बट दोज चैप्टर्स वी विल रिवाइज इन अ शॉर्ट वे. Okay, we will just I'll give you short revision so that you can recall all these chapters. I know that you have given exam also after studying those chapters, but we will just recall those chapters so that you can we feel that we have learned about those. Okay, so children, chapter number 1. What is the chapter number 1? Smart senses. Okay, smart senses. Under this chapter you have studied about our senses. You know that we have 5 senses. Okay, and those 5 senses we will write the name first. Senses we can write eye, means our sense organs we will write here, and then we write the senses. Eye, you know, eye is a organ which we use to see. Okay, so here its senses, sight. We can see anything what is happening around us, we can see with the help of our eyes. And second sense organ is nose. With the help of nose, you know that we can smell it, we can smell the foul smell, or we can identify that whether it is a delicious food smell is there, or which kind of fragrance is there. We can identify when anybody close our eyes, then also we can identify easily with the help of our nose, with the by taking its smell. So sense is called smell, and our sense organ is nose. And third sense organ is ears. With the help of our ears we can hear many things. Okay, and whatever happening, and very small means a little bit sound also coming from anywhere, we can easily identify that something happening around us. Understand? When anybody is coming near us, or if we not see them, if it is at the back, then also you can easily identify that somebody is coming near you. Okay, and ears are helping to listen, or we can say hear. So hearing is a sense, and ears are the sense organs. So fourth one is skin. Skin, what skin help you? Skin is also one of the important sense organ. Skin help us to detect the changes in the environment, means whether it is cool or hot, you can easily identify with the help of your skin. Okay, if anybody pricks you, or if anybody little bit also try to touch you, then also you can feel that something happening. Okay, sometimes insects bite when we sleep, that time also we identify that something happening, because there are the receptors, those cells, sensory cells, which are present in the skin also. Okay, and it also help us to identify the changes in around in our environment. So our this sense is called touch, sense of touch. So these are the four sense organs. And fifth one is tongue. Tongue means It is a sense organ. It is a sense organ, and what it identifies means what kind of sense it identifies, that is taste. As you know that when you take sweet, or sometime you take salty, sometime you take sour or bitter, these all kind of taste can be easily identified by your tongue. And on the tongue, so many taste buds are there. Okay, so you can identify easily with the help of your tongue which kind of taste of that particular food you are having. Okay, so this is all about these senses. And children, in this chapter you have studied about the different animals also. As you know that many animals have different kind of senses, and those senses which are more powerful than the human beings. As you know that eagles or many birds which are flying so high in the sky, so those animals have more powerful eyesight, or we can say this vision, sight, sense than the human beings. It can see the prey, its prey, from very far away, means from so much height. It can see what is there moving on the ground. Okay, so those kind of animals also you have studied in this. You have studied an example of tiger also. Tiger can feel these vibrations, or snakes are also, they can feel vibrations when anything all around it, or it can detect the heat of other animals also. Okay, and in the same way you have studied about I think frog also there, or some other animals also. So many examples you have studied related to these senses, means not only human beings, other animals are also having many kind of senses. With the help of those senses, those animals they can detect that sense, that whatever happening around our environment, understand, or their environment. And children, about these senses, how we can detect, because in our sense organs, just like eye, nose, ear, skin or tongue, there are some cells which are very special cells. Those are called receptors, and those cells are only able to find those kind of senses, means these kind of senses. Okay, and those are special cells. When those special cells, they receive any stimulus from the environment or all around us, then what happening around us, those all the receptors, they give us information that what we see, what we smell, and what kind of weather is there, cool or hot, and what kind of taste of any food is there, what which kind of sounds are coming from all around us. Those all these senses, they are detected by the receptors, and after detection that message reached to our brain, and then our brain tell us that what is actually detected by our sense organs. Okay, brain is the main controller of our body. You have studied in previous chapter, means the previous classes. So brain tells us, because brain controls all these sense organs. Okay, so children, in this chapter we have studied about the sense organs, and chapter number 2 and chapter number 3, that you know you have studied about the inspirational personalities. Okay, inspirational personalities which give you inspiration, just like in second chapter you have studied about that famous dancer which is called Sudha Chandran. Okay, Sudha Chandran, as you know, when you have learned or heard the story of Sudha Chandran, you have seen that she lost her leg, one leg, and without leg also she tried to, means with the help of artificial leg also, she tried to perform dance performances, and then she got so many gold medals or other prizes, many prizes. Means after that lacking of their organ also, she does so well, or she did so well. Okay, so God has given us so many opportunities. Many of the times we get opportunities but we miss them. So inspiration, what kind of inspiration we can get from Sudha Chandran? That every time we don't think that we are having this lacking, we can't do this, we can't do that, don't think that. In spite of those all the means lackings also, we can do many things. Main is our willpower and main is our inspiration, which tells us that how we can perform better. Okay, in any area, in case of study also, in case of your future, that goal also, what is there, your aim, what you want to become, that all the things depend on your inspirational power. Okay, so we should have strong inspiration so that we can do better in our life. Okay, so that from Sudha Chandran's story, we have you have learned this kind of inspirational story, and second story you have studied about the Dhyan Chand, and third chapter is based on the Dhyan Chand. Dhyan Chand, you know that he was the famous hockey player. Okay, and he also got many awards and medals also because of its his means inspiration, or we can say because of his strong willpower, and after so many struggling also he got his position and he got his name and fame. Okay, he is a hockey player, and Dhyan Chand, why he chosen hockey? That he loves hockey because hockey is our national game. You know that national game of India is hockey. So we should know that many of us, we try to always watch cricket or other games also. Games are not, all the games are good, but we should promote our national game. Means we should try to involve in that also because it is our national game. Okay, and children, along with the studies, we should also have interest in games also, because you know that sports and games, all these are good for our better health, and they can promote, it is a kind of exercise also, and it can promote or it can improve our immunity. Okay, our fight power against any kind of diseases. So that chapter is mainly based, means why we they have included that third chapter in your book, to promote our national game, and as well as they want to tell you that what is the importance of games in anybody's life. Means not only with the help of studies we can become anything, we can make our future, or we can make our career in case of in the field of games also. Okay, so children, this is all about the three chapters which you have studied in the month of April. Okay, so in next video we will start next chapter. Okay, so thank you. Jai Gurudev.